having a discussion. This is my friend Joey. And we were discussing the fact that so many people think poodles are sissies. Well, if anybody says that about Joey, he simply refers them to his best friend, Michael Landon. Hello. Glad to get back with you.
Well, actually, nobody ever calls him a poodle. He's a knish. He's a poodle, but it's called a knish. He's in between a miniature and a standard.
And he's only a baby.
Yeah, he's only 5 months.
And Joey, of course, has nothing to do with little Joe.
No.
Well, I've been doing a thing called the Thanksgiving Parade with your Pa Cartwright for Logan's
Dad, Dad, of course. Yes.
Well, we're going to have a parade of our very own right here on the Pet Set.
Welcome to the Pet Set. Starring Betty White, and a favorite guy in everybody's set, Michael Landon.
Loving going on. You say he's 5 months old.
Right, yeah.
And he should get to be a pretty good size if he's a knish. That's one above the between the mini and the standard, isn't it?
Yeah, it came as a shock to me. I thought it was just a miniature, and then he got bigger than my miniature real fast.
How many do you have?
Three. We've got a toy and a miniature in this one.
Well, then all you have to do is get a standard and an imperial and a teacup and you'll have a whole. Are they all black?
No, I've got a brown and a silver one. Oh. And a silver one.
And you just have been kind of partial to poodles.
Yeah, well, we had a little black cat, but the cat didn't get along with the poodles too well. So when I gave the cat away, I promised the kids I'd get another animal. So we got a little black dog.
How many kids, Mike?
I have five.
Oh, so you have a pretty good full house.
Girl. Right.
We see you with horses so much. Are you a big horse man, or?
No, I'd like a busman's holiday. I ride the horses on the show, but that's about it.
Go home and have the poodles when you get home to relax. Well, you know, every once in a while somebody around here says, what are you, do you prefer dogs to cats? You have more dogs than you do cats? And it's anything but. We'd have aardvarks if we could. You know, we just like anything around here. But in a studio situation, cats are not as easy to handle. You have to hold them. If they get away or spook with the audience or anything, then we have a problem. And there are so many different kinds of dogs. There are something like 116 breeds of dogs. So it gives a little more variety, but all cats are welcome. All anything with a leg on each corner is welcome. And two-legged birds. People, not
birds.
You know, it's funny how styles have changed. Poodles, of course, have come into their own, I guess it's, what, the last 10 years?
Yeah.
But styles have changed through the years. Fads, I suppose, like fashion and anything else in dogs. And I'd kind of like you to come on over and meet a man who can attest to that and even has the papers to prove it. Would you like to come meet a friend of mine?
Sure would.
Excuse us.
Bring
with you, Mike. Well, maybe not the papers, Mike, but certainly the magazine. This is Dick Beauchamp, editor and publisher of Kennel Review magazine. How long has Kennel Review been the number one dog magazine?
Since 1898.
That long? You haven't been with it that long.
No, I stepped in about 10 years ago.
Well, we're going to have a parade, and we thought it would be a good idea if you were here as our authority to keep us honest. Are you game for that?
I'm game.
We thought it would be fun to kind of compare the styles of the 10 most popular breeds of dogs of 50 years ago and compare them to the 10 most favorite breeds of dogs today. You like that idea?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Everybody ready?
And it's a beautiful morning here in Pasadena, Betty.
Now cut that out. We're going to play this really